Link is a powerful tool for manipulating data in VB.NET, and the range function is one of its most versatile features. Whether you're working with RPA and UiPath, or just want to learn more about the capabilities of VB.NET, this function can help you accomplish a wide range of tasks. But don't just take my word for it. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use range function in general. I will also show you some advanced techniques and overloads that will take your programming skills to the next level. So, if you're ready to master link and range function, hit play and let's get started. Range function generates a sequence of integer numbers within a specified range. It has only one overload, which is the following. We always have to use the class enumerable, then the function range. This function has two input parameters of type integer, start and count. Start stands for the value of the first integer in the sequence. Count stands for the number of sequential integers to generate. For example, if you want to create a sequence of numbers from 1 to 10, you can use the following statement. The number 1 is the first integer number that will be generated. From this number, 10 numbers will be generated. It means, the output of this statement will be the following sequence that contains the numbers from 1 to 10. Or this statement, for example. It generates numbers from 3 to 4, because we start with number 3, and the count should be only 2. And so on, we can create a sequence of numbers using this function. This is how to use the function. But where can we use it? Let's start with the first use of this function. I have here a sequence in UiPath. Here is a variable counter, of type integer, with the default value 1. Assume I have a process, where I have some steps, which should be executed more than one time in a sequence. For example, the following three steps should be executed 5 times. To do that, we have to use a loop, for example, while activity. Here I use the variable counter in the condition. Inside the activity, I have the activities I want to execute. I added write line activity at the beginning to print a text in the output console to know how many iterations do we have. Here are the steps I want to execute after each other. And the last activity is an assign activity to increment the counter in each iteration. In summary, this sequence is to execute some activities 5 times. Let's execute the code to check how many iterations do we have. As you see, I have 5 iterations. In other words, the activities or the steps I want to execute are executed 5 times. This is what I want to do. So, everything is okay and it works fine. But I can also do exact the same using range function. Let's see how to do that. For that, I will first add for each activity. Let's change the name of this variable here to item. And as list of items, I will use the range function. As mentioned, we write enumerable, then range function with two parameters. I want to execute the steps 5 times, therefore I need to generate 5 numbers, for example from 1 to 5. In this way, I have 5 numbers inside the list now. Let's add this write line activity inside this activity to check how many iterations do we have. Here I will use item variable instead of counter variable. Item is the variable from for each activity. And now I will copy the steps I want to execute inside this loop. Now I have everything I need. This loop is to execute the steps 5 times. Let's delete this activity. And also this variable. As you see, I have only a loop without creating any variables. Let's execute the code to check the result. As you see, I have again 5 iterations. It's exact the same as what we had using the old way. So, it works exact the same. Using this way, we don't need to create variables to control the loop, and we don't need to increment any variables or to do anything more. This is the first use case, where and how can we use range function. Let's check another use case for this function. I can create an array of numbers using range function. For that, I can use assign activity. On the left side, I have to add an array variable. It should be of type integer. And on the right side, I can write the following statement. Here I am creating a sequence of numbers from 1 to 20. After that, I am converting the output to array. In this way, I will have the numbers from 1 to 20 inside the array variable. The same can be also done for a list of integer. On the left side, I am adding the list variable. It should be list of integer. And on the right side, I will write this statement. Here I'm also creating a sequence of numbers from 1 to 20. But here I use the function to list, to convert the output to list. I can also use negative numbers as parameters, for example the following statement. As result I will get the following numbers. And so on we can use the function to generate a sequence of integer numbers. Let's now check another use case, to get only the even numbers from a specific range. Even numbers are for example, 2, 4, 6, 8, etc. Assume I want to get the even numbers between 1 and 20. For that I can use the following link query. Here I use the function as data source in from statement. This will return a sequence of numbers from 1 to 20. This statement is exact the same, as when I write for example this one. There is no difference between both. But using range function is easier. After that I have a condition to get only the even numbers. At the end I am selecting the numbers, that meet the condition. After the query I have the function to array, to convert the output to array. Using this query I will get the following numbers. They will be stored in an array of integer. I can also use the same query to get the odd numbers. For that I only have to change the condition to this one. In this case I will get only the odd numbers, which are the following. This was also a use case, where we can calculate specific numbers inside a specific range. In conclusion, the range function is an incredibly powerful and versatile feature of Link, that can be used in a wide range of scenarios. In future videos, I will be using this function to demonstrate advanced techniques, such as checking if a number is a prime number, finding prime numbers within a range, and determining if a number is an Armstrong number. I hope this video has given you a solid understanding of how to use range function, and inspire you to explore its full potential. So, go ahead and give it a try, and don't hesitate to reach out to us if you have any questions or need further assistance. Thank you for watching.